In the meantime, China's cabinet has appointed Eric Chan as the head of the new Hong Kong National Security Committee. The newly formed panel, to be supervised by the central government, is to help safeguard national security and the implementation of the new law in the city. Mr. Chan is the director of the chief executive's office and was previously the director of the Immigration Department. Roland Lim has more.
Yes, the Committee to Safeguard National Security in Hong Kong is one of two new agencies to safeguard and formulate policies relating to the new law. The committee will be chaired by the chief executive, Carrie Lam. Eric Chan has been appointed its secretary general, and its other members include heads of the city's finance, justice, administration, security, police and customs department. The committee itself is under the supervision and accountable to the central government, and Beijing will be sending its national security advisor to sit in on these meetings. It is the other Chinese agency, the Office for Safeguarding National Security, set up in Hong Kong that will have sweeping powers to make policy recommendations to the government and to pursue cases here. That means that mainland security officers, part of the new agency, will operate on Hong Kong soil for the first time. And while they have to abide by local laws, Hong Kong authorities have no oversight of the agency's activities, which have left many critics worried. Meantime, a day after violence erupted in parts of Hong Kong Island when thousands took to the streets to protest against the new law, police have made a fresh arrest. A 22-year-old male suspect was nabbed on board a Cathay Pacific plane trying to flee the city on a midnight flight to London. Now, he's being held in connection with stabbing a police officer with a dagger while a clearance operation was being carried out at 4 p.m. Wednesday. The policeman sustained serious injury to his left shoulder, and police say they have arrested at least 370 people, including 10 detained on suspicion of violating the new law for displaying flags or possessing material deemed to be promoting Hong Kong independence. Hong Kong's sole delegate to the National People's Congress Standing Committee, Tam Yu Chong of the DAB party, suggested that the newly implemented security law wasn't as harsh as it's made out to seem, as a large number of protesters came out to protest. Now, Mr. Tam added that the law, which carries a maximum penalty of life imprisonment, was harsh, but no one would have dared defied it otherwise, and pointed out that though the level of violence and the number of people who took part in the protests was lower as compared to previous rallies.